लास्ट क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग होर्सनेस ऑफ वॉइस और स्पीच डिसऑर्डर. सो विल गो टू द सेकेंड कॉमन सिम्टम इन लैरिंग्स विच इज योर स्ट्राइडर. वॉट इज स्ट्राइडर? स्ट्राइडर इज अ हाई पिच्ड अबनॉर्मल नॉइजी ब्रेथ साउंड विच कैन बी हर्ड विदाउट यूजिंग अ स्टेथोस्कोप. तुम लोग यू नो अबाउट द अदर टाइप्स ऑफ ब्रेथ साउंड लाइक ब्रॉन्कियल ब्रेथ साउंड है, वेसिकुलर ब्रेथ साउंड है, वीज है, रेल्स है, क्रेपिटस है. ऑल दीज साउंड आर ब्रेथ साउंड आर हर्ड बाई यूजिंग अ स्टेथोस्कोप. वेरस स्ट्राइडर भी एक ऐसा ब्रेथ साउंड है विच इज अ हाई इंटेंस साउंड. सो इट इज अ नॉइजी साउंड विच इज अबनॉर्मल एंड हाई पिच्ड. इट कैन बी हर्ड इवन विदाउट यूजिंग अ स्टेथोस्कोप. सो वेन एवर अ पेशेंट ऑफ एनी स्ट्राइडरस पैथोलॉजी कम्स टू यू, okay, even if it is a very highly crowded, heavily crowded OPD, you should be able to pick up or you should be able to identify that a stridorous patient is entering the OPD. So all your importance should be going to that patient, stridorous patient, because it is a emergency condition. So when a stridorous patient enters a OPD, even without turning your head, you should be able to identify that a patient has come with stridor. So the definition of stridor is that it's a high-pitched, abnormal, noisy breath sound which can be heard without using a stethoscope. So when is a stridor produced? We have seen when is a voice produced. Whenever air passes through a partially closed or closed vocal cord, when it just opens, it will produce some sound. सो ये अबनॉर्मल नॉइजी साउंड है तो इट शुड बी अ टर्बुलेंट एयर विच इज पासिंग थ्रू अ ट्रैक्ट विच इज पार्शियली ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड. ओके, सो द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन कैन बी देयर एनीवेयर इन द वाइड एयरवे. ओके, ब्रोंकियोल्स में जो भी ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन है इट विल नॉट प्रोड्यूस स्ट्राइडर, इट विल प्रोड्यूस अदर अबनॉर्मल ब्रेथ साउंड विच कैन बी हर्ड विद स्टेथोस्कोप, दैट वी विल डिस्कस लेटर. If it is there, if the lesion is there or if the obstruction is there at the level of primary bronchus, uske upar trachea, uske upar subglottis, glottis, supraglottis, hypopharynx, oropharynx or even oral cavity with lesions involving palate which is obstructing both the nasal cavity nasopharynx and the oral cavity oropharynx, is a patient dono root se properly ब्रीद नहीं कर पा रहा. इफ अ लीशन इज देयर इन द पैलेट, इमेजिन इट इज सच अ बिग स्पेस ऑक्यूपाइंग लीशन विच इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिंग बोथ द ओरल कैविटी एंड द नेजल कैविटी विच इज हैविंग वेरी मिनिमल ओपनिंग हियर एंड देयर सो दैट सम अमाउंट ऑफ एयर इज पासिंग थ्रू द गैप्स. सच पेशेंट कैन ऑल्सो डेवलप स्ट्राइडर. सो द लेवल ऑफ ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन कैन बी देयर फ्रॉम एनीवेयर बिटवीन द नेजल कैविटी और ओरल कैविटी अप टू द primary bronchus. Any such lesions can produce stridor. Okay, so stridor is produced when a turbulent air passes through a partially obstructed respiratory tract. It can be upper respiratory tract or lower respiratory tract or it can be a mix of both. Okay, so we know what is stridor now. How to differentiate that from snoring or something called as stertor? Snoring, you know what is snoring? When the loose soft tissue of the upper respiratory tract vibrates when the air passes through the lumen, it is called as snoring. Okay, it can be seen in obese patients or patients who has lost weight suddenly, a heavy patient and he has undergone a drastic weight reduction. Okay, aise patients mein mil sakta hai, hypothyroid patients mein mil sakta hai, or if there is big tongue patients, so many conditions the patients can develop snoring. And stertor bhi aise condition hai, here the vibrating medium is not the soft tissue of the pharynx or larynx, but it is a secreted saliva or any other secretions which is pooled in the cavities in the upper respiratory tract. Like aapka valicula mein koi secretions hai, nasal cavity nasopharynx mein koi secretions ho, aapka piriform sinus mein kuch नीचे लीशन है इसकी वजह से ऊपर सेक्रेशंस कलेक्ट हो गया हो. इफ द सेक्रेशंस आर गेटिंग वाइब्रेटेड इट इज कॉल्ड अ स्टर्टर. सो स्ट्राइडर और स्नोरिंग स्टर्टर को कैसे डिफरेंशिएट करना है? स्ट्राइडर कैन बी सीन both when the patient is sleeping as well as when the patient is awake. Whereas snoring or stertor can be seen only when the patient is sleeping. Otherwise, it will not be there. Okay. So what are the types of stridor? Based on the phase of respiration where the sound is produced, we can divide it into inspiratory stridor, expiratory stridor. And if it is present on both the phases, inspiration as well as expiration, we call it as biphasic stridor. Okay. In the diagram, you can clearly see inspiratory striders are seen in upper respiratory tract up to the level of glottis or above the level of glottis, upper supraglottis tuck. Okay. Glottis, subglottis and upper part of trachea is my lesion hai, so it can be a biphasic strider. Uski niche hai, to aapko expiratory strider mil sakta hai. Breath sounds bhi aise, if you are going towards the lower respiratory tracheobronchial tree, aapko secondary bronchus mein hai, tertiary bronchus mein hai, aapko respiratory alveolus mein hai, koi lesion ho, then the patient's abnormal breath sounds will be seen during expiration. Imagine bronchial asthma. Bronchial asthma mein bronchus mein aapko lesion hoga. Lesion means the pathology will be in the bronchus. So muscles spasm ho jata hai. So the patient will be having finding when the patient exhales. So jo wheeze hota hai wo usually expiration mein, exhalation mein hota hai. So if the size of the, or if the diameter of the lumen of respiratory tract, when if it is going on reducing, wo jo bhi aapka abnormal sounds produce hota hai wo towards expiration hota hai. If it is a wide lumen respiratory tract, like aapko supraglottis hai, pharynx hai, wahan inspiratory hota hai. Jo beech ka area hai usme dono level mein hoga, biphasic hota hai. Okay, in which condition we will see biphasic stridor and all, we will see later on in the following topics. So what is respiratory tract? This is a passage which for the inhaled or exhaled air, it starts from the nose and goes up to the alveolus. Okay, respiratory alveolus tak jata hai. It can be from nose, nosopharynx, nasopharynx, which goes into oropharynx, which is a common cavity. If the patient is breathing through the oral cavity of mouth, then it will be oral cavity, oropharynx and further downwards. Okay. Isme significance kya hai? There is one difference. A newborn baby, a neonate, immediately born baby, it is a strict nose breather. The baby cannot breathe through the oral cavity of the mouth. So if the patient is having, if the baby is having bilateral complete choanal atresia, then the baby will not be able to breathe through the nose, and the baby, newborn baby, is not a mouth breather anyway. So the patient or the baby will be having complete respiratory obstruction, which can go on to respiratory, lead on to respiratory, complete respiratory distress, respiratory obstruction. So delivery hone ke baad, within few minutes, if the baby is becoming blue, pura pura cyanotic ho gaya, and you are not seeing any breathing, oral cavity se frothing aane lagta hai, so then you should be, even without any investigation, you should be thinking about bilateral complete choanal atresia. Okay, how will you confirm the condition? You take a small feeding tube, okay, made of silicone, which is flexible, non-traumatic, and you try to pass it through the nasal cavity. And if you are not able to see the tip of the suction tube or the feeding tube coming into the throat, oral cavity mein nahi dikh raha, oropharynx mein nahi dikh raha. If it is, or if you are feeling a proper obstruction, resistance mil raha on both the sides of the nasal cavity, that can be a confirmatory, bedside confirmatory choanal atresia. Whenever you are passing a suction tube or feeding tube, or koi bhi tube hoga, to usme ek lead lining hota hai. Lead is a radio opaque material, so there will be a lead lining on the wall of the suction tube or the feeding tube. So if you pass it through and you are taking an x-ray, you can see the tube coiled within the nasal cavity, because it is not being able to pass through the choana into the oropharynx, nasopharynx and oropharynx. Okay, so obstruction from nose or oral cavity till main bronchus can cause stridor. Jo secondary bronchus mein hai, tertiary bronchus mein hai, वो सब आपको वीस प्रोड्यूस करता है, ब्रॉन्कियल ब्रेथसोन्स प्रोड्यूस होता है, बट नॉट स्ट्राइडर। स्ट्राइडर प्रोड्यूस होने के लिए जो डायमीटर होगा एयरवे की वो तो थोड़ा सा बड़ा होना चाहिए। ओके, यू शुड नो व्हाट इज अपर एंड लोअर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्स। और डायरेक्टली ईएनटी में कोई रोल नहीं है। इफ यू आर रीडिंग मेडिसिन, अपर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट इन्फेक्शन क्या है, लोअर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट इन्फेक्शन मीनिंग निमोनिया क्या है, ऐसा पता करने के लिए यू शुड नो व्हाट इज अपर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट, अप टू विच लोकेशन इट इज अपर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट एंड बिलो विच इट इज कॉल्ड एज लोअर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट यू शुड नो। अप टू लैरिंग्स इट इज अपर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट, बिलो लैरिंग्स ट्रकिया ऑनवर्ड्स इट इज लोअर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट इन्फेक्शंस। So, what are the causes of stridor? Any disease or any symptomatology, if you are reading about, if it is a headache, don't try to mug up the causes of headache. Always try to make some classification. I always say, ear discharge है तो उसको भी causes का कोई classification रख लो. Inflammatory हो सकता है, traumatic हो सकता है ऐसे. So, for stridor, you have at least two classification known as congenital and acquired. कंजेनेटल में द कॉमनली आस्क्ड क्वेश्चन इज लेरिंगो मलेशिया, लेरिंजियल वेब्स, दिस आर ऑल कॉमनली रिपीटेडली आस्क्ड क्वेश्चंस आल्सो इन योर थियरी एग्जामिनेशंस। सो द कॉसेस, कंजेनेटल कॉसेस फॉर स्ट्राइडर, कंजेनेटल कॉसेस होगा तो फिर क्या होगा, द पेशेंट हु इज प्रेजेंटिंग प्रेजेंटिंग टू यू विल बी ए नियोनेट, न्यू बॉर्न बेबी होगा और एन इन्फेंट होगा अंडर 1 ईयर ऑफ एज। ओके, सो कॉमन कॉसेस आर लेरिंगो मलेशिया, लेरिंगो मलेशिया इज द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज फॉर स्ट्राइडर इन ए न्यू बॉर्न बेबी। Other causes are subglottic stenosis, which is of congenital type. There is acquired subglottic stenosis also. Subglottic hemangioma, it is always congenital. Laryngeal webs, congenital, cyst, congenital. Vocal cord palsy, very rare cases are seen congenitally. Most of the vocal cord palsies are acquired. Okay, but there are few conditions, neurological, central neurological CNS conditions, which can cause bilateral vocal cord palsies. Okay, and facial malformations like retrognathia, severe retrognathia is there, meaning the mandible is retracted very posteriorly, much inwards. Okay, what will happen? What is giving attachment? What is getting attached to the mandible? Your supra hyoid scrap muscles, and mainly your tongue is getting attached to the mandible. So if the mandible is pushed inwards, the tongue, the bulk of the tongue will also be pushed inwards. Okay, so that is causing obstruction to the oropharynx and hypopharynx. Okay, that obstruction, if it is significant enough, then the patient can have congenital stridor. Okay, and acquired conditions, again acquired mein bahut sara causes hai, so you again make a list of classification. Under acquired you can have traumatic conditions, inflammatory conditions, neurological, foreign body, or miscellaneous condition mein aata hai. You cannot classify foreign body into any of the pathology. It can be neoplastic disease or it can be a immunological condition like angioedema, which is a type of hypersensitivity. So in trauma, again, if the trauma is causing any maxillary or mandibular fractures, okay, which is making the tongue to fall back, which is obstructing the airway, then the patient can have stridor. Okay, then laryngeal injury, if there is a case of crush injury to the throat, okay, koi blunt injury se crush ho gaya ya koi wooden stick se maar diya, so then there can be fracture of all your laryngeal cartilages, which can lead on to collapse of your laryngeal lumen and the patient can develop stridor. Accidental ho sakta hai, self inflicted ho sakta hai, homicidal ho sakta hai, or sometimes iatrogenic bhi ho sakta hai. Iatrogenic बहुत रेयर है, बट स्टिल इट इज पॉसिबल. ओके, एंड सेल्फ इन्फ्लिक्टेड एंड होमिसाइडल में यूजुअली क्रश इंजुरी नहीं मिलता, इट विल बी अ कट इंजुरी. यू कैन सी मल्टीपल हेसिटेशन कट्स फॉलोड बाय अ डीप कट व्हिच इज कटिंग द कटिंग थ्रू द प्लैटिस्मा स्ट्रैप मसल्स एंड डैमेजिंग द लैरिंजियल कार्टिलेज, एनी ऑफ द लैरिंजियल कार्टिलेज. ओके, और थायराइड कार्टिलेज भी हो सकता है, क्राइकॉर्ड भी हो सकता है. ओके, एंड अदर फेशियल इंजरीज व्हिच यू हैव सीन, मैंडिबुलर फ्रैक्चर हो सकता है, मैक्सिलरी फ्रैक्चर हो सकता है. देन इन्फ्लेमेटरी कंडीशंस, ओके, क्रॉनिक इन्फ्लेमेटरी कंडीशंस में आपका ट्यूबरक्लोसिस तो आ ही जाता है एज ऑलवेज. ट्यूबरक्लोसिस के साथ साथ आपको बाकी अदर क्रॉनिक इन्फ्लेमेशन लाइक सार्कोइडोसिस आ सकता है, वेजिनस आ सकता है, बट दे आर ऑल वेरी रेयर. बट लेरिंजियल टीबी in India, it is not that much uncommon to get. If you are having a good clinical acumen, you should be able to easily pick up laryngeal tuberculosis. Laryngeal tuberculosis, before doing a laryngoscopy, it is a diagnosis by exclusion. You try to exclude all other reasons and then try to arrive at laryngeal tuberculosis. Saath saath mein patient ko associated other tubercular histories can be there. Pulmonary TB ho sakta saath saath mein. Okay. We are mainly concerned about acute inflammatory conditions like Quincy. Quincy, you know what is Quincy? It is peritonsillar abscess. Okay, unilateral swelling of the tonsil, which is due to collection of fluid in the peritonsillar space. Okay, that can compromise the oropharynx, and the patient can develop stridor. Okay, isme stridor kyun hoga? Because it is a very virulent inflammation. Infection jo ho raha, it is always highly infectious and virulent. Uske wajah se kafi significant localized edema hoga. So you might be thinking it is only in the oropharynx, nasopharynx to theek hi hai, to patient ko respiratory distress or stridor kyun ho raha? It can push the palate upwards, it can compromise the nasopharynx also, and the Quincy, if it is significantly big in size, it can go posteriorly and it can block the oropharynx completely, so the patient can develop stridor. Okay, then diphtheria pehle ke time jaisa aajkal itna common nahi hai, but still in few states diphtheria are still common because of lack of proper vaccinations. Okay, faecal diphtheria bhi ho sakta hai, where we'll be seeing ulcerative membranous lesions over the palatine tonsils bilaterally. Gray color ka aapka membrane hoga. If you peel the membrane below the membrane, the bed from where the membrane was removed, it will bleed and the patient will have large cervical lymphadenopathy. Jugulodigastric lymph nodes kafi bada bada aapko milega. Okay, by this, looking at this, you can think about faecal diphtheria. Laryngeal diphtheria, again, to diagnose laryngeal diphtheria is little difficult. Okay, the patient will present as an acute stridorous patient. Okay, if you take the history, the patient will give history of not taking any vaccine, mainly DPT vaccine properly nahi liya hoga. By this you can arrive at laryngeal diphtheria. Many a times when the patient is having diphtheria extending up to larynx, usko saath saath faecal diphtheria bhi hoga. So you will arrive at the final diagnosis by looking at the faecal diphtheria. Faecal diphtheria mein kafi significant stridor ho, so then you will think that the patient is having laryngeal extension also. Infectious mononucleosis pathology mein bahut common topic hai. This one of the finding in infectious mononucleosis is kissing tonsils. Jo dono side ka tonsil hota hai wo itna bada ho jata hai, that will come and meet in between, so it is classically given the name kissing tonsils. So jab tonsil dono aapas mein aake touch ho gaya, to aapka airway compromise ho sakta hai because of the hypertrophy of the tonsils, the patient might develop stridor. Laryngeal tuberculosis एंड एक क्रॉनिकली प्रेजेंट होता है, इतना एक्यूट प्रेजेंटेशन नहीं होता है. एंड अदर कॉमन कंडीशन विच यू एनकाउंटर इन पीडियाट्रिक्स आर एक्यूट एपिग्लॉटिटिस एंड एक्यूट एलटीबी. एलटीबी इज लैरिंगियो ट्रकियो ब्रोंकाइटिस. इसमें लैरिंग्स में भी होगा, ट्रकिया में भी होगा, ब्रोंकस में भी होगा इन्फ्लेमेशन. ओके, सो एक्यूट एपिग्लॉटिटिस, ऑल दीज थिंग्स वी विल रीड इन डिटेल लेटर ऑन. Retropharyngeal abscess, most common cause for retropharyngeal abscess is pot spine. Okay, if the pot spine is involving the cervical vertebra, okay, uski saath saath aapko jo retropharyngeal space hota hai usme aapka cold abscess aake collect ho sakta hai. It will not present as a acute condition. Gradually the patient will start developing dysphagia. Kafi bada ho gaya abscess, so then the patient's voice can also get changed, and when you examine the patient, you will be able to see a proper swelling in the posterior pharyngeal wall in the midline. Okay, and aapka patient ka CT cervical spine karke dekhte hain, so you will be seeing erosions in the cervical vertebra. Okay, these are inflammatory conditions. Then comes neurological conditions, where you have to read about this main topic, which is vocal cord paralysis. Stridor causing vocal cord paralysis is bilateral recurrent laryngeal nerve or abductor nerve abductor paralysis. If it is unilateral paralysis, there will be only voice change, which you have read in the last class. उसके लिए हम thyroplasty वगैरह करते हैं. If it is a bilateral recurrent laryngeal nerve palsy, then the patient will not present with voice change. The patient will present acutely with sudden respiratory distress. Okay. तो ये काफी easy है आपको diagnose करने में. Patient will not be able to vocalize, but the patient will have sudden onset of stridor. Okay. Other conditions like foreign bodies. Foreign bodies usually childhood में present होता है. Foreign body of the airway mainly. Okay. Commonest foreign body to be seen in the airway in India is peanuts. Peanuts are chana. Chana ki dal ya peanut. ये सब बहुत जल्दी जल्दी में बच्चा खाते हैं या without chewing if the patient if the child is trying to swallow. Or when the patient is speaking and trying to eat, suddenly it can enter the airway. And if it is obstructing at the level of larynx and trachea, okay, the mode of presentation will be very acute and severe. Okay, suddenly sinus ho jate hain bacche, and many a times they will not be even able to reach the emergency. Usse pehle bhi kabhi death ho ja sakta hai. If it is a significantly large sized foreign body. If it is in the level of any one of the bronchus, main bronchus or the secondary bronchus, then the foreign body might be missed for even months. काफी महीना तक वो presenting नहीं करते हैं. Sometimes the patient will present to pediatrics directly, like a case of pneumonitis. X-ray करके देखा तो एक side में आपको opacity मिलेगा, okay? And the pediatricians they might be treating the patient with misdiagnosis as a case of pneumonitis. Okay, बार बार treatment लेता रहेगा थोड़ा improve हो जाते हैं patient, and again after 2-3 weeks the patient will come back with similar complaints. Okay, after 2 or 3 episodes of similar treatment, failed treatments, they might send the patient to us, suspecting that the patient might be having airway foreign body. Okay, if in those conditions if we do a flexible fiber optic laryngoscopy, we might be able to see the foreign body in the larynx or trachea, and if we are going up to the bronchus by bronchoscopy, we might see the foreign body there. Okay. Other conditions are neoplasms. They can be even benign neoplasms or malignant neoplasm of pharynx, base of tongue. Pharynx मतलब base of tongue में कोई lesion है, या larynx में supraglottic, glottic, subglottic कहीं भी कोई lesion हो, और extra luminal neoplasms. माने directly larynx में कोई neoplasm नहीं है, but there are any other lesions in the structure surrounding the larynx, like commonly आपको thyroid neoplasm, aplastic carcinoma of thyroid commonly compresses the trachea and the patient might develop stridor. कभी patient को पीछे से esophageal carcinoma है, then also the patient might develop stridor. Rare conditions like आपको upper superior mediastinal lymph nodes बड़ा हो रखा है, तो then also then the patients might develop stridor. Okay, the less seen thing is angioedema of larynx and trachea. Angioedema of the other central mucosal organs are more common. Like आपको lips में edema हो जा रहा, tongue में edema हो जा रहा, these are all common. Larynx and trachea में angioedema directly हो जाना, केवल larynx and trachea में. It can be associated with angioedema of lip and tongue, but isolated angioedema of your larynx and trachea are very very rare. Okay, so some patient is coming to you with stridor, साथ साथ में lips में भी swelling है, tongue भी काफी edematous दिख रहा है, and the patient gives history of taking in any allergic, non-allergic material. Okay, किसी देखो seafood का allergy हो सकता है, peanuts का allergy हो सकता है, so whatever, if they have a known history of allergy to these edible items, then you can easily arrive at the diagnosis. उनको anti-inflammatory drugs, आपको steroids दे दीजिए, antihistamines दे दीजिए, and with that the patient can very easily respond. So stridor पूरा in detail में management पढ़ने से पहले, एक-एक condition का management पढ़ने से पहले, we'll revise the anatomy. Last class में हम केवल voice production के related anatomy पढ़े हैं, अभी airway के related anatomy थोड़ा देख लेते हैं. Larynx can be divided into 3 parts as you know. The superior most is supraglottis, the middle one is glottis, and the lower one is epiglottis. You can see how it is divided in the diagram. From the uppermost tip of your epiglottis up to the ventricle or just below the false vocal cord, that is supraglottis. So false vocal cord is a part of supraglottis. Epiglottis is a part of supraglottis. Periepiglottic folds are parts of supraglottis. Piriform fossa is a part of supraglottis. Okay. Then what is glottis? Glottis includes mainly your vocal cord only. Okay, well, vocal cord akela nahi hai. Half to 1 centimeter, the area below the vocal cord, that also comes under glottis. Not just this portion, but up to this portion. Okay. Then what is subglottis? From the lower end of glottis, jo half to 1 centimeter, it is not clearly defined. It is a transition zone. Okay, wo transition zone ke niche se leke cricoid cartilage, either epiglottis ka upper end bol rahe the, and here the cricoid cartilage, the lowermost end of cricoid cartilage up to that point, it is subglottis. So we have three subsides: supraglottis, glottis, and subglottis. Okay. उसमें एक कैच है, लैरिंग्स में सबसे नैरोस्ट पोर्शन कैन बी आस्क्ड इन योर वाइवा और इन योर एमसीक्यूज आल्सो. इफ इट इज एडल्ट पेशेंट, द नैरोस्ट पोर्शन इज योर रीमा ग्लॉटिडस और द ओपनिंग बिटवीन द वोकल कॉर्ड्स, द स्पेस बिटवीन द वोकल कॉर्ड्स, दैट इज द नैरोस्ट पोर्शन. वेरस इन चिल्ड्रन के बिलो 7 ईयर्स, उन लोग को सब ग्लॉटिक एरिया है, दैट इज द नैरोस्ट पोर्शन. ओके, this is the narrowest portion because cricoid keeps growing even after that age. So up to that age, cricoid is the narrowest portion. After that adulthood may the rhemoglottidus is the narrowest portion. Okay, so in case of foreign body ingestion, okay, if it is a significantly large sized foreign body, okay, some toys, plastic toys or anything the patient is playing with, if the patient puts it in the mouth and tries to swallow, if it enters airway by mistake, in case of child, it is not a compulsion that it should be stuck at the level of vocal cords. It can even pass through the vocal cord, but can get arrested in the subglottic area. Okay, so just upper se direct laryngoscopy kar liya, nahi dikh raha, so you do not rule out the case. Okay, so outline of larynx, it has a cartilaginous framework, skeletal framework. Okay, there are total of 9 cartilages, 3 pad, matlab 6 cartilages and 3 end pad. So total of 9 cartilages constitute the skeletal framework of the larynx. Okay, all the cartilages, they are either connected or covered by few ligaments and membranes. Okay, they connect the cartilages. Okay, and at two points we have a proper joint, not a soft tissue connection, but we have a proper joint between two cartilage. One is cricothyroid joints, a set of cricothyroid joints on both the sides, and a set of cricoarytenoid joint on both the sides. Both the joints, both cricothyroid and cricoarytenoid, both are synovial type of joints. What is the significance of knowing what type of joint is there in larynx? Synovial joints are prone to get involved in degenerative arthritis or autoimmune arthritis conditions. Okay, so if it is a case of rheumatoid arthritis, okay, we have a joint to offer to rheumatoid arthritis. We have two joints to offer to rheumatoid arthritis. So jo bhi hyaline cartilage aapka hoga, synovial material hoga, everything can get involved in the rheumatoid arthritis. So not only joint pain, the patient can of rheumatoid arthritis can even present with hoarseness of voice and throat pain. Okay, hamesha ye nahi hai aapko fingers or small joints mein pain hai. Finger ka joint kitna chota hai, usse chota joint apna laryngeal joints hai. So the patient can even present with hoarseness of voice and throat pain. Okay, ab hamesha usko pharyngitis, laryngitis jaisa soch ke aap treatment dete jayenge. If it is a middle aged female without doing a RA factor assessment nahi kar rahe hain, so then you will be able to give a good result to such patients. Hamesha first visit mein aise patient hum suspect nahi karte hain. If the patient is not responding to a treatment of laryngitis, then you have to suspect this also. It is a rare phenomenon, but still you should have it in your mind. Okay, then two type of joints we have seen, and muscles, there are two set of, we have to divide again, and there are two sets. We can divide it into intrinsic group of laryngeal muscles एन एक्सट्रिंसिक ग्रुप ऑफ लैरिंजियल मसल्स. इंट्रिंसिक ग्रुप है और लैरिंग्स की अंदर होता है एंड उसका काम टू मूव द वोकल कॉर्ड मेनली. वेरस एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स उसका काम क्या है, इट द वर्क ऑफ एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स इज टू मूव द लैरिंग्स एज सच. वोकल कॉर्ड को मूव करने का काम इंट्रिंसिक मसल्स करता है. पूरा लैरिंग्स को मूव करना, एलिवेट करना, डिप्रेस करना, एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर रिट्रैक्शन प्रोट्रैक्शन करना, ऑल दिस आर डन बाय एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स. ओके, ये सब हो गया तो इनर सरफेस ऑफ द इनर ल्यूमिनल सरफेस ऑफ द लैरिंग्स इज लाइंड बाय इनर एपिथेलियल लाइनिंग. ओके, रेस्पिरेटरी लाइनिंग एपिथेलियम व्हिच इज सीलिएटेड कोलोनरी एपिथेलियम इज सीन जस्ट लाइक अदर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट एक्सेप्ट in two places. One is vocal cord that we have seen in the last class also. Okay, jo cover theory mein hum pad rahe the, it forms the cover. Usme stratified squamous epithelium hota hai, that is why it is pearly white in color. And stratified non-keratinized epithelium is seen in the ary epiglottic fold also. Okay, so we have on the larynx outline we have five things to read. One is skeletal framework. उसमें नो कार्टिलेज है, उसके बारे में हमको पढ़ना है. मेम्ब्रेन्स एंड लिगामेंट्स, इट कनेक्ट्स बिटवीन द कार्टिलेजेस एंड फॉर्म्स, इट कवर्स द डेड स्पेस और द ओपनिंग्स बिटवीन द कार्टिलेजेस. देन जॉइंट्स, मसल्स एंड एपिथेलियल लाइनिंग. कार्टिलेज, विल रीड अबाउट द अनपैड कार्टिलेज फर्स्ट बिकॉज दे आर लार्जर इन साइज. दिस इज द फर्स्ट कार्टिलेज यू विल बी सीइंग इफ यू आर एग्जामिनिंग डूइंग अ इनडायरेक्ट लैरिंगोस्कोपी. ओके, द फर्स्ट कार्टिलेज टू बी सीन इज epiglottis. Okay, it is a leaf shaped cartilage. It has hyaline component but more of elastic cartilage is there. Okay, it is not purely an elastic cartilage, it has hyaline components also but more percentage of the composition is by elastic cartilage, fibroelastic cartilage. Okay, what is the function of your epiglottis? Okay, parts of epiglottis, there are two surfaces, lingual surface and laryngeal surface. If you look at this, okay, posterior we are looking from behind and this picture it is looking at the larynx from front. Okay, from front hai to uske upar aapka tongue hoga. So this surface, the anterior surface of epiglottis is called as lingual surface and the posterior surface of epiglottis it is called as laryngeal surface because it is coming and closing the larynx, it is facing towards the larynx. Okay, it has lateral borders. Dono lateral border mein aapko ary epiglottic fold attached rehta hai. This is your arytenoid cartilage which is sitting over the cricoid lamina. This portion is your arytenoid cartilage. Ye arytenoid cartilage se dono lateral border ko border mein attach hone ke liye ek membrane hota hai, that is ary epiglottic fold. So lateral borders give attachment to ary epiglottic fold. And lingual surface mein do मोटा मोटा लिगामेंट्स, वी कैनॉट कॉल इट एस मेम्ब्रेन बिकॉज इट इज नॉट फ्लैट बट इट इज अ थिक ट्यूबुलर स्ट्रक्चर. आपका एंटीरियरली होगा बट इट इज नॉट सीन फ्रॉम हियर. वन लिगामेंट अटैचेस बिटवीन द हायड एंड एपिग्लॉटिस एंड वन लिगामेंट अटैचेस फ्रॉम थायराइड कार्टिलेज टू द एपिग्लॉटिस. सो वी गिव द सिमिलर नेम्स, हायो एपिग्लॉटिक मेम्ब्रेन एंड थायरो एपिग्लॉटिक मेम्ब्रेन. दोनों कंडीशन में आपको मिड लाइन में ये दोनों होता है एंड इसके ऊपर as we have seen base of tongue is there. So to the base of tongue we have two type of folds. जो मीडियन होता है that is median glosso epiglottic fold and laterally जो होता है that is lateral glosso epiglottic fold. Okay, इसको membrane नाम भी कोई बुक में देते हैं, कोई बुक में ligament के नाम भी देते हैं. Okay, it is not a pure membrane or not a pure ligament. Okay, so main function the epiglottis ka function bhi to kuch hona hai. The function of epiglottis is to protect the airway, larynx, trachea, ye sab ko protect karna during deglutition. So one of the function of larynx you have seen is protection of lower airway. It is done by your epiglottis, a part of it is done by epiglottis also. Epiglottis bhi band hota hai, sath mein aapko vocal cord bhi adduction mein aa jata hai during swallowing. So there are multiple things which are protecting the lower airway. One of the main component in that protecting mechanism is done by your epiglottis. Okay, this ka relationship anteriorly it is related to a space called as ary anterior epi- and pre-epiglottic space. Okay, mainly there are no significant structures there. There are few lymph nodes and mainly filled with fat. Okay, pre-epiglottic space is in midline, single space hota hai, and dono side laterally it opens into two spaces on each side. One space on each side called as paraglottic spaces. Okay, both the paraglottic spaces are directly not in contact. They communicate through the anteriorly placed pre-epiglottic space. Okay. Then comes the thyroid cartilage, which is the largest one. It is a pure hyaline cartilage. Okay, but with the age, advancement of age, after 40-45 years of age, the hyaline cartilage is it will gradually get calcified, and at a older age group, you will see the hyaline the tracheal thyroid cartilage to be like a hard bone. Okay, iska significance kya hai? Calcify hone ka significance, in last class we have read about some surgeries, thyroplasty. Usme thyroid cartilage ko hum modify karte hain, we increase or decrease the size of thyroid cartilage. So imagine if it is a 70 year old male for whom the thyroid cartilage is properly calcified and bone like, usme aap incision laga ke aap cut nahi kar paoge thyroid cartilage ko. For that you have to use a proper drill, micro drill system. Aise ear surgeries mein drill karke bone ko mastectomy karte hain, bone ko remove karte hain. Aise you have to use a drill system to cut through the thyroid cartilage to do any other procedure inside the thyroid cartilage. Okay, so this also has two surfaces, the outer surface and inner surface. Outer surface jo broad shield jaisa dikhta hai usko hum right and left lamina mein divide karte hain. This is right lamina, this is left lamina. On both the lamina you will be having oblique prominence. Okay, oblique line of thyroid cartilage bolte hain, where all the strap muscles, suprahyoid and infrahyoid strap muscles, will come and get attached. Okay, it has two set of horns. Ye dono jo superiorly dikh raha hai, these two are superior horns, and these two which are going and getting articulated to the cricoid cartilage, these are called lower or inferior horns. Okay, cricoid cartilage, the significance, one significance of cricoid cartilage if you want to remember is it is a complete ring. Epiglottis ek flat structure tha, thyroid cartilage ek shield shaped structure tha, only cricoid cartilage forms a complete ring. Significance for this complete ring is only this sustains or maintains the lumen of your larynx. Otherwise esophagus jaisa ye bhi collapse ho sakta hai. Okay, because surrounding muscles can go into contraction and it can collapse the lumen. To prevent this collapse or closure of the lumen, this is done by your ring of cricoid cartilage. Okay, this is anterior end and this is posterior end. Anterior part of cricoid cartilage is thin, and it is called as arch of your thyroid cartilage, ring or arch of thyroid cartilage, whereas the posterior aspect of your cricoid cartilage is tall and flat, so we call it as lamina, just like your thyroid cartilage laminae. Okay, it has two articulating surfaces. The one on the superior aspect, it goes and articulates to the arytenoid. In this picture you would have seen, here you can see, this is the lamina of your cricoid cartilage. On the superior aspect of the lamina, the arytenoid cartilage is coming and sitting, and it is forming a joint just like just here. Okay, so these are the articulating surfaces for your arytenoid cartilage. Okay, and on the posterolateral surface of your cricoid lamina, you have articulating surface for your inferior horn of your thyroid cartilage. You are seeing this is coming and getting articulated to this portion. Okay, this portion. Okay, arytenoid cartilage. Okay, this is the only one paired cartilage which you have to read about. Okay, baki corniculate hai, cuneiform hai, aur sab ka zyada koi significance hai nahi. Only one set of cartilage, paired cartilage, you have to read about or know about is arytenoid cartilage, which is indeed having a very significant role in voice production and respiration. Okay, because it this process of your arytenoid cartilage, which is projecting anteriorly this is anterior end, okay, this process, okay, it is magnified here. This process is called as vocal process, which is getting the giving the posterior attachment to your vocal ligament or the vocal cords directly, okay. So whenever this vocal process moves by action of any following muscles, we are going to read about them, by the muscles come and get attached to the second process. This process is called as muscular process because all the muscles come and get attached to this process, either on the anterior aspect or the posterior aspect of this muscular process. If the muscles contract, this will be pulled backwards or pulled anteriorly, which can in turn move the vocal process, which is getting attached to the vocal cord. So movement of vocal cord is by the movement of the vocal process. Okay. इसमें जो सुपीरियरली है अपेक्स है, इट गिव्स सीट, इट सीट्स द कॉर्निकुलेट कार्टिलेज एंड द क्यूनिफॉर्म कार्टिलेज फर्दर. सो कॉर्निकुलेट एंड क्यूनिफॉर्म्स, यू जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर दीज टू पॉइंट्स. द अदर नेम फॉर कॉर्निकुलेट कार्टिलेज इज कार्टिलेजेस ऑफ सैंटोरिनी. अदर नेम फॉर क्यूनिफॉर्म इज कार्टिलेज ऑफ रिस्बर्ग. इसके अलावा और कुछ इसमें ज्यादा पढ़ने के मतलब नहीं है, बिकॉज from the apex, okay, from here the aryepiglottic fold arises and goes and attaches anteriorly to the lateral border of your epiglottis, okay, on the aryepiglottic fold, okay, you get these two cartilages embedded on the aryepiglottic fold. It is not having any significant role in voice production or respiration, nothing, okay. It is like how you read the sesamoid bones, tendon ke andar ya muscle ke andar jo bone form ho jata hai, aise ye सेसमॉइड बोन्स ही बोलते हैं कि क्या बोन्स बोलते हैं उसको, वॉट एवर, ओके, यू फाइंड इट इन द एरिएपिग्लॉटिक फोल्ड्स. लैरिंजियल जॉइंट्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन, देयर आर टू जॉइंट्स, क्राइकोथायराइड जॉइंट एंड क्राइकोएरेटिनॉइड जॉइंट, बोथ आर साइनोवियल जॉइंट्स, दे माइट गेट इन्वॉल्वड इन रूमेटॉइड आर्थराइटिस पैथोलॉजी. ओके, क्राइकोथायराइड जॉइंट, ओके, दिस इज हैविंग ओनली वन सिग्निफिकेंस, ओके, दिस इज क्राइकोथायराइड जॉइंट, ओके. The recurrent laryngeal nerve, okay, it comes and divides into two groups. External group, which goes and supplies all the musculature, intrinsic muscles of your larynx, except cricothyroid, okay. And internal branch, there is one internal branch which is going into the lumen of the larynx and supplies the epithelium, okay. That gives the sensory supply to the epithelium, okay. That is also through the recurrent laryngeal nerve, branch of recurrent laryngeal nerve only. So the branching usually occurs at this point where you are having the cricothyroid joint and it turns into the larynx. So this is one of the landmark for identification of recurrent laryngeal nerve during any thyroid surgeries or any other neck surgeries, okay. And cricothyroid joint, it is the most important joint which you have to read because it is moving every single time when you are trying to speak or when you are taking a breath. Okay, if you are inspiring, the vocal cord should abduct, and when you are speaking, the vocal cord should come in contact, adduction hona chahiye. So for every single movement of respiration, the cricoarytenoid joint should move. Ye jab move hoga to tabhi ye vocal process move ho sakta hai, okay. So it is the more important and more mobile laryngeal joint, which is cricoarytenoid. Coming to the membranes and ligaments, we can divide the membranes and ligaments also into intrinsic and extrinsic group, just like your muscles. We'll see now. Extrinsic groups, ये बाहर से भी हम देख सकते हैं. They are more in number. Okay, this is hyoid bone. This is thyroid cartilage. So the membrane or the ligament between these two will be called as thyrohyoid membrane and thyrohyoid ligaments. जो बीच में है, this is thickened portion. So we can call this as ligament. And this flattened thin portion, we call these as thyrohyoid membrane. Okay, and in the thyrohyoid membrane, you will be having two defects on both the sides. One defect here and one defect here. Okay, through which the external branch of superior laryngeal nerve or the superior laryngeal nerve goes into the larynx. Okay, here recurrent laryngeal nerve, how it goes into the larynx, we have seen the superior laryngeal nerve and the vessel goes into the larynx through these defects, one in this side and one in this side on thyrohyoid membranes. Okay, and here दिस इज द लोअर एंड ऑफ योर थायराइड कार्टिलेज एंड दिस इज क्राइकॉइड. सो ये दोनों के बीच में क्राइकोथायराइड मेम्ब्रेन एंड लिगामेंट्स होता है जो ये है. दिस इज योर क्राइकोथायराइड मेम्ब्रेन जो आपको ब्राउन कलर का दिख रहा है, दैट इज नॉट अ मेम्ब्रेन, इट इज क्राइकोथायराइड मसल मस्कुलेचर. ओके एंड हियर द स्ट्रैप मसल्स आर डिसेक्टेड सो यू आर नॉट एबल टू सी द extrinsic laryngeal muscles attachment. Here you will be having an oblique line where the strap muscles will come and cover. Iske upar aise aapko hoga. If you cut open the platysma and elevate the flap, you will not directly see this anatomy. Iske upar aapka laryngeal strap muscle, sorry, strap muscles of the neck will be seen. Okay, usko aap dissect karoge ya retract karoge, so then you will be able to see this anatomy. ओके इसमें भी इस एरिया में आपको थायराइड ग्लैंड आता है. हियर द थायराइड ग्लैंड इज रिमूव्ड एंड ओनली द लैरिंग्स पासेस शोन विद ट्रकिया. ओके सो एक्सट्रिंसिक में आपको थायराहायड मेम्ब्रेन आ जाता है, लिगामेंट आ जाता है, हायो एपिग्लॉटिक हायड एंड एपिग्लॉटस के बीच में एंड थायराइड एंड एपिग्लॉटस के बीच में एक थिक बैंड लाइक लिगामेंट होता है विच आर्टिकुलेट्स और विच फिक्सेस द एपिग्लॉटस टू द लैरिंग्स. ओके दैट विल बी सीन. It will be just seen behind the thyrohyoid membrane. इसके just अंदर होगा. Okay. And cricothyroid and cricotracheal membrane. This is cricotracheal membrane between the cricoid cartilage and the first ring of trachea. You get cricotracheal membrane. Okay. What is the significance of this membrane? Cricothyroid membrane. Okay. If some patient is having sudden foreign body inhalation हो गया and it is stuck at the level of larynx. Okay, trachea के नीचे नहीं गया, bronchus में नहीं गया, ऊपर ऊपर है, तो then it can cause complete obstruction. Suddenly the patient will go into respiratory obstruction and failure. ऐसे condition में you will not be able to have a proper time to do tracheostomy. If the patient is lying on a roadside and you are doing your third year MBBS, third year curriculum में हो, तो you will not be able to perform tracheostomy also. Or if you are a paramedical staff, you will not be able to do a proper tracheostomy. So in those conditions, you can do some procedure called as mini tracheostomy or cricothyroidotomy. Okay, this membrane, this is cricothyroid membrane, and if you make a opening or hole in this membrane, it is called as cricothyroidotomy. Okay, so this is more easy. Okay, you palpate the Adam's apple. This point, this projection, this thyroid cartilage prominence is called as Adam's apple, as you know. Okay, इसको आप track करते हुए आओ, you will be able to feel the lower border of your thyroid cartilage. इसके नीचे आप 1 centimeter आप फिर track down करेंगे, तो then you will be able to see the anterior arch of your cricoid cartilage. So you will be able to see a dip between these two solid structures, which is your cricothyroid membrane. So in that point where you see, either you put in a wide bore needle, either 14 gauge ke ya 16 gauge ka aap ek needle bhi dal sakte hain, even if you are afraid to make an incision. Okay, you can put a needle. Tab tak tracheostomy nahi ho pa raha, tab tak thoda bahut breathing air to ye needle ke through, wide bore needle ke through bhi ja sakta to keep the patient alive. Okay, and if you are having a sharp knife or blade in your hand, you can just make a stab incision and you can open the airway just below the level of obstruction. That is called as mini tracheostomy. Okay, so these are the significance of your extrinsic membranes and ligaments. Intrinsic membranes do hi hai. Intrinsic, just like your muscles, it acts or it is present inside the lumen. Inside the lumen. Okay, so inside the lumen, here a sagittal cut is made on the larynx and they are showing. Okay, here you can see two ligaments or two membranes. One, the first one is aryepiglottic fold or quadrangular membrane. Okay, from the arytenoid up to the epiglottis, from here to here, from this apex up to the occal process, here it is forming one border. The lateral border of epiglottis is forming second border. There is one free border. ऐसे एक membrane आप imagine कर लिए, there will be a free border and a lower border. The lower border of the aryepiglottic fold is also called as false occal cord or vestibular fold. Okay, and this is the first intrinsic membrane. Second intrinsic membrane is your vocal ligament. This, okay, ये vocal cord है, इसके just नीचे एक fibrous strand जाता है, which is condensation of your cricoarytenoid muscle, the medial most end. Okay, that is called as vocal ligament. So these two are the intrinsic laryngeal membrane and ligaments. Okay. So the lowermost end of your quadrangular cartilage forms your false vocal cord, and the vocal ligament, the covering of the vocal ligament forms the vocal cord, true vocal cords. Okay. So both false vocal cords and true vocal cords are formed by intrinsic membranes of the larynx. Okay. Then comes the laryngeal muscles and innervation. Okay. मेनली जो एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स है उसका जस्ट आप नाम ही नाम याद करो वही बहुत है. द एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स, ओके, वी कैन डिवाइड द एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स इनटू टू ग्रुप्स, सुप्रा हायड, हायड बोन की ऊपर, और हायड बोन की नीचे. जो हायड बोन की ऊपर रहता है, इट पुल्स द लैरिंग्स अपवर्ड्स एंड समटाइम्स एंटीरियरली. ओके, एंड जो हायड बोन की नीचे है, दैट पुल्स द और डिप्रेसेस द लैरिंग्स. ओके, वॉइस का पिच एंड टोन इम्प्रूव करने के लिए वो वॉइस को ऊपर, लैरिंग्स को ऊपर करना, नीचे करना, ये सब काम में आता है. टू चेंज द शेप ऑफ द वोकल ट्रैक्ट और फोनेट्री ट्रैक्ट. ओके, सो जस्ट रिमेंबर द नेम्स. सुप्राहायड मसल्स आर माइलोहायड, जीनियोहायड, दिस टू गो एंड गेट्स अटैच्ड टू द मैंडिबल. स्टाइलोहायड बिटवीन द स्टाइलॉइड प्रोसेस एंड द हायड बोन. डाइगैस्ट्रिक अगेन बिटवीन द मैस्टॉइड प्रोमिनेंस up to the hyoid bone and back to the mandible. Stylopharyngeus, between the styloid process and the pharynx, hypopharynx, palatopharyngeus, self-lingopharyngeus. Even though if they are not directly attaching into the larynx, the contraction of these also can lead on to elevation of your larynx. They can elevate the larynx superiorly. Okay. Infrahyoids are thyrohyoid, sternothyroid, sternohyoid, and omohyoid muscles. These four sets bilaterally they are present. They depress the larynx. हम लोगों काम का muscles है वो intrinsic muscles है. Okay, because they are involved in the mobility of your vocal cord, breathing and phonation के लिए जो जरूरत है. Okay, so posterior cricothyroid. Okay, the only abductor of the vocal cord. जो ओकल ग्लॉटिक ओपनिंग है उसको ओपन करने के लिए एक ही मसल है, विच इज योर पोस्टीरियर क्राइको अरेटिनॉइड. ओके, दिस इज एंटीरियर एंड, दिस इज पोस्टीरियर एंड लैटरल, एंड हियर यू आर सीइंग द क्राइकॉइड लैमिना. सो फ्रॉम द मिड पॉइंट द मसल इज ऑरिजिनेटिंग फ्रॉम द मिड लाइन, गोस बिहाइंड द क्राइकॉइड कार्टिलेज एंड कम्स एंड गेट्स अटैच्ड टू द vocal muscular process of your arytenoid cartilage. Okay, this is muscular process of your arytenoid cartilage. It is coming and getting attached. This is PCA, posterior cricoarytenoid. Imagine if the muscle is getting contracted, this is a fixed point, this cannot move, whereas your muscular process can move. When the muscle is contracting, the contraction will be in this direction. Okay, from here to here. So the arytenoid process, arytenoid cartilage, the muscular process, which is ultimately a part of arytenoid cartilage, is pulled laterally in this direction. It will move this way. So this will move the vocal process laterally in this way. So this can abduct the vocal cord. Whereas this muscle is called lateral cricoarytenoid. From here to here, it is coming and getting attached here. When this moves, this is the fixed portion and this is the mobile portion. Okay, here the mobility will be in this direction from here to here. So here it is fixed, here it is mobile. When this contracts, this ultimately pushes the vocal cord medially, vocal cord and the vocal process and vocal cord medially. So this abducts, this is main adductor of your vocal cord. So posterior cricoarytenoid, it is the only abductor supplied by recurrent laryngeal nerve. Okay, it arises from the medial surface of the lamina. Lamina se muscular process of arytenoid mein attach hota hai. Then lateral cricoarytenoid, it arises from the lateral part of the arch and goes to the muscular process. It adducts the cord, again supplied by recurrent laryngeal nerve. All the muscles, the there are five set of muscles: posterior PCA, LCA, cricothyroid CT, transverse arytenoid, and interarytenoid. It can be considered as a single group. Okay, it is this transverse between the arytenoid inside the between the arytenoids. Okay, if it is parallel, when the muscle fibers are parallel, it is called as transverse arytenoid. When the muscle fibers are oblique, if it is in X shaped like this, then that group of muscle fibers are called as oblique arytenoid muscles. Transarytenoid and oblique arytenoid. Okay, they just adduct and they just bring the arytenoids closer together. That is also supplied by recurrent laryngeal nerve. Thyroarytenoid and vocalis muscle. Even though it is a single muscle, the medial most portion of thyroarytenoid is called as vocalis. जो उसकी ऊपर कंडेंसेशन ऑफ सॉफ्ट टिश्यू मिलता है, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वोकल लिगामेंट. जो वोकल लिगामेंट की ऊपर आपका एपिथेलियल लाइनिंग भी आ जाता है, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वोकल कॉर्ड. ओके, सो दैट इज थायरोआरिटेनॉइड एंड वोकलिस, दैट इज आल्सो सप्लाइड बाय रिकरेंट लैरिंजियल नर्व. ओके, ओनली वन मसल व्हिच इज सप्लाइड नॉट बाय द रिकरेंट लैरिंजियल नर्व एंड बाय द एक्सटर्नल ब्रांच ऑफ सुपीरियर लैरिंजियल नर्व इज ट्राइकोथायरॉइड मसल, व्हिच इज अ टेंसर ऑफ वोकल कॉर्ड. ओके, बाकी सब इधर अडक्ट करता है, अबडक्ट करता है, वेरस क्राइकोथायराइड है, इट इज द ओनली टेंसर ऑफ द वोकल कॉर्ड. टेंसर ऑफ द वोकल कॉर्ड, इट इज ऑपोजिट टू द एक्शन ऑफ अबडक्शन. अबडक्ट नहीं करता है, बट इट हेल्प्स अडक्शन ओनली. अल्टीमेटली इट हेल्प्स इन अडक्शन ओनली. ओके, सो दीस आर योर क्राइको अरेटिनाइड एंड वोकालिस मसल. दिस इज थायरोअरेटिनाइड मसल. ऑल दिस यू कैन सी. So there are two laws in this portion which is cut. Here it is mentioned as Simon's law, S-E-M-O-N, Simon's law. It was postulated in 1881 by Simon. And kya postulate karna cha rahe the? If we, ultimately we will read about the laryngeal paralysis also. Okay, so when recurrent laryngeal nerve undergoes paralysis, okay, here you can see recurrent laryngeal nerve supplies both abductors as well as adductors of the vocal cord. But when there is complete recurrent laryngeal nerve paralysis, okay, the vocal cord assumes cadaveric position, which is paramedian position. Paramedian position, this is complete adduction. Here the vocal cord is in median position. Paramedian, the vocal cord will not be at this point, but it will be at this point. At complete abduction, the vocal cord can open even up to this point. Okay, in complete recurrent laryngeal nerve paralysis, the vocal cord comes and settles in paramedian or cadaveric position, we can call. Okay, so why it assumes cadaveric position, that is explained by these two theories. One is Simon's law and second is Wagner-Grossman theory, which came later on. It is the widely accepted one, Wagner-Grossman. Okay, so Simon's law mein kya hai? The Simon's law says whenever there is recurrent laryngeal nerve paralysis, okay, it supplies both abductor fibers as well as adductor fibers. But during paralysis, abductor fibers are the first one to get damaged in recurrent laryngeal nerve paralysis. So even if it is a grade 1 paralysis, imagine it is a, there are three grades, okay, grade 1, 2 and 3 recurrent laryngeal nerve paralysis. Okay, in grade 1, it is initial phase of paralysis. There also abductor fibers, even in grade 1, abductor fibers are abolished. So the vocal cord cannot abduct, it cannot open. Okay, but the adductor muscles, they are still functional because they will get damaged at a higher grade of paralysis or at a later phase of paralysis. So abduction is not happening at all because abductor paralysis ho chuka hai. Okay, aapko adductor पूरा पूरा काम कर रहा है. ऑल्सो योर टेंसर मसल विच इज सप्लाइड बाई सुपीरियर लैरिंजियल नर्व, विच इज सप्लाइड बाई सुपीरियर लैरिंजियल नर्व, क्राइको थायराइड, दैट इज ऑल्सो फंक्शनल बिकॉज वी आर रीडिंग ओनली अबाउट रिकरेंट लैरिंजियल नर्व पैल्सी. सुपीरियर लैरिंजियल नर्व, दैट इज ऑल्सो फंक्शनल. ओके, सो योर अडक्टर्स आर फंक्शनिंग एंड टेंसर विच इज अ सप्लीमेंटरी एक्शन टू अडक्शन, अडक्शन को वो सप्लीमेंट करता है, दैट इज ऑल्सो फंक्शनिंग. सो इन grade 1 paralysis, you will expect the vocal cord to be in midline position, it will be in proper midline position. Okay, then it the grade of paralysis increases, it is going to grade 2 from grade 1. Isme kya hoga? Some part of your adductor fibers, they also will get dysfunctional, they will also not function. So abduction bhi nahi ho raha aur complete adduction bhi nahi ho raha, only tension ki wajah se thoda sa medial hook medialis ho jata hai. So abduction bilkul nahi hoga, adduction thoda slow ho gaya, but thoda bahut tension ki wajah se adduction is still possible. So it will come into paramedian position. So if there is one sided paralysis, imagine this side recurrent laryngeal grade 2 paralysis is there. So the distance from the midline to the vocal cord will be around 2 to 4 millimeter. Okay, that is grade 2. Okay, so abhi dekhi, abhi complete recurrent laryngeal paralysis ho chuka hai. Usme abduction bilkul khatam ho gaya, adduction bhi bilkul khatam ho gaya. So both opposing actions are gone. So vocal cord will not move at all. पहले थोड़ा बहुत when the patient tries to phonate, adduction का fibers थोड़ा बचा रहने की वजह से थोड़ा सा muscle का twitching, vocal cord का twitching हो सकता है paralyzed side में. Whereas in grade 3 palsy, it will be completely fixed vocal cord in paramedian position. वो complete adduction में भी नहीं जाता है, complete abduction में भी जाता है, just because of the tension provided by the cricothyroid muscle, which is supplied by external branch of superior laryngeal nerve. वो एक टेंस पोजीशन में आके पैरामीडियन कैडावरिक पोजीशन में फिक्स हो जाता है. ओके, सो दैट आल्सो विल बी अराउंड 2 टू 4 मिलीमीटर ओनली, बिटवीन 2 टू 4 मिलीमीटर. इफ इट इज अ बाइलेटरल रिकरेंट लैरिंजियल पैल्सी ऑफ ग्रेड 3 सीवियरिटी, द ग्लॉटिक ओपनिंग विल बी फिक्स्ड एंड इट विल बी मैक्सिमम ऑफ 4 मिलीमीटर ओनली. ओके, सो जस्ट 4 मिलीमीटर की ओपनिंग के थ्रू पेशेंट कितने भी breathing करेगा तो the patient will be having significant respiratory obstruction. So this is a surgical emergency. तुरंत tracheostomy करना चाहिए. Okay. So Wagner-Grossman theory, it was postulated after Simmons theory, 16 years after Simmons theory, and वो ज़्यादा accepted है. इसमें लिखा है complete paralysis of recurrent laryngeal nerve. The cord lies in paramedian position because of intact cricothyroid muscle which is supplied by superior laryngeal nerve. क्योंकि recurrent laryngeal nerve only is damaged, not superior laryngeal nerve. Okay, and this will assume an intermediate or cadaveric position or paramedian position because of loss of adductive as well as abductive forces. Okay, so coming into inlets, how many inlets we have to know, how many openings into the larynx we have to know. This one is called, the first one we have to know about is laryngeal inlet, which is the space between bilateral aryepiglottic fold. Dono aryepiglottic fold ki beech ka space hai, that is called as vestibule, and the opening into the vestibule is called as laryngeal inlet. Okay, the lower border of your aryepiglottic fold is your vestibular folds. Okay, so dono vestibular fold ki beech mein jo space hai, that is called as rima vestibuli, or the space between two false vocal cords. Uske niche aapko true vocal cords aa jata hai, वो दोनों के बीच का जो ओपनिंग रहता है दैट इज रीमा ग्लॉटिडिस. ओके, लैरिंजियल इनलेट कैन बी, इट कैन ओपन एंड क्लोज बाय द एक्शन ऑफ योर एपिग्लॉटिस. एपिग्लॉटिस कैसे मूव होता है, फॉर एपिग्लॉटिस मेम्ब्रेन के साथ साथ थोड़ा मसल फाइबर्स रहता है, इट कैन पुल और इट कैन ओपन द एपिग्लॉटिस ओपन. ओके, इट कैन लेट द एपिग्लॉटिस ओपन. ओके, सो रीमा ग्लॉटिडिस इट इज वेरिएबल. ओके, कभी बिल्कुल खत्म हो जाता है when there is complete adduction, or it can be wide open when there is complete abduction. Okay, so coming to the causes of your stridor, जो जो हम causes में देखे हैं, so we can go into, after seeing this much anatomy, we can go into the causes of congenital stridor. आज केवल congenital cause देखते हैं, बाकी सब आज का time हो ही गया. So the commonest cause of congenital stridor, our congenital cause for stridor is laryngomalacia. Okay, I have written this is the commonest cause of stridor in neonates as well as infants, because laryngomalacia most of the time it will not present immediately after birth. The commonest age at which the laryngomalacia can present to you is at around 2 months of age. Okay, immediately after birth it is not significantly seen. Okay, it is seen in a normally delivered टर्म बॉर्न बेबी, मेल में थोड़ा सा प्रीडोमिनेंस ज्यादा है सेक्सुअल प्रीडोमिनेंस, एंड एसोसिएशन विद अदर न्यूरोलॉजिकल कंडीशंस एंड अदर कंजेनिटल एनोमलीज आल्सो कॉमन. ओके, न्यूरोलॉजिकल एनोमलीज मतलब आपको सेरिब्रल पैल्सी सीपी वगैरह के साथ साथ ये मिल सकता है. ओके, बिकॉज द कॉज फॉर लैरिंगोमलेसिया इज नॉट क्लियर. कार्टिलेज इमेच्योरिटी बोलते हैं, थोड़े लोग न्यूरोलॉजिकल कॉसेस बोलते हैं. इफ न्यूरोलॉजिकल कॉसेस इज proved later on to be the cause for laryngomalacia, वो cerebral palsy के साथ साथ तो associated होने की cause हम explain कर सकते हैं. And there can be other anatomical malformations of larynx also, which can cause laryngomalacia. Okay, it clinically presents as a low pitched inspiratory stridor because laryngomalacia is there up to the level of glottis only, upper part of your larynx. So inspiratory stridor मिलेगा आपको. Okay. The stridor increases whenever there is agitation or cry, or when the child tries to phonate violently. Okay, when the child tries to phonate violently, air will pass through the glottis, negative pressure will be created, and the redundant mucosa, which is a clinical finding in your laryngomalacia, the redundant mucosa meaning loose mucosa, you can imagine the loose mucosa will be further sucked into the lumen. Okay, jo bhi loose rehta hai negative pressure generate hone se, it can be further pulled into the towards the lumen of your larynx, which can further reduce the lumen of your larynx. So in such conditions the stridor can increase, or when the baby is trying to feed, okay, that time also the to suckle in, that negative pressure is generated. Again, there can be sucking in of redundant mucosa, which can reduce the lumen of your larynx, which can cause stridor. Okay. Commonly, 2 months of age mein present karte hain, and up to 75% of cases, they resolve spontaneously without any surgical intervention by the age of 9 months to 18 months. Mostly, 1 year mein aapko achcha kasa improvement दिखने लग जाता है पेरेंट्स को, एंड बाय 18 मंथ्स 75% ऑफ केसेस विल रिजॉल्व स्पॉन्टेनियसली. कंप्लीट रेजोल्यूशन आई एम सेइंग, ओके, 75% केसेस में हो जाता है. बट अदर रिमेनिंग 25% ऑफ केस आल्सो, मोस्ट ऑफ द केस विल रिजॉल्व सिग्निफिकेंटली. ओके, इतना सिग्निफिकेंट इंप्रूवमेंट आ जाता है तो इट विल नॉट वारंट एनी सर्जिकल इंटरवेंशन. ओके, सर्जरी करके आप एयरवे को पैटर्न रखने तक का कोई जरूरत कभी पड़ता नहीं है. ओके, सो अप टू 18 मंथ्स ऑफ एज हम जो पेरेंट को हम जस्ट एजुकेट करना पड़ेगा व्हाट ऑल कैन बी द कॉम्प्लिकेशंस व्हिच माइट कम बिकॉज ऑफ लैरिंगोमलेसिया. कॉम्प्लिकेशंस लाइक रिकरेंट और परसिस्टेंट एपनिया एंड हाइपोक्सिया कैन लीड ऑन टू पल्मोनरी हाइपरटेंशन कैन अकर, एंड देन फेलियर टू थ्राइव. पेशेंट का जो ग्रोथ होना चाहिए, वेट इंक्रीज होना चाहिए, वो सब ठीक से नहीं होगा, एंड देयर कैन बी रिकरेंट एस्पिरेशन इनटू द लोअर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्स व्हिच कैन गिव मल्टीपल एपिसोड्स ऑफ न्यूमोनाइटिस एंड न्यूमोनिया. हाउ विल यू डायग्नोस द कंडीशन? ओके, डायग्नोसिस इज डन बाय विजुअल एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द लैरिंग्स. ओके, ईदर बाय डूइंग अ फाइबर ऑप्टिक लैरिंगोस्कोपी और माइक्रो लैरिंजियल एग्जामिनेशन, और जस्ट बाय पुटिंग इन अ डायरेक्ट लैरिंगोस्कोप and see the epiglottis. Okay, the classical sign which is mentioned in the textbook is omega sign. This is omega sign. Okay, if you examine the anteriorly, the omega will be, this curvature will be seen anteriorly, and these are aryepiglottic folds. This flat lines are your aryepiglottic folds. Okay, this is aryepiglottic fold. This fold is narrowed and the curvature of your epiglottis is further exaggerated. वो ऐसे सेमीसर्कल की साइज में होना चाहिए. इट बिकम्स अ ऑलमोस्ट मोर देन अ सेमीसर्कल, काफी ज्यादा सर्कुलर हो जाता है आपका एपिग्लॉटिस. ओके, सो दिस इज सीन इन ग्रेड 3 और क्लासिफिकेशन में 3rd ग्रेड. द मैक्सिमम ग्रेड में आपको प्रॉपर ओमेगा साइन मिलता है, एंड इन द इनिशियल लेस सीवियर ग्रेड्स, ग्रेड 1 एंड ग्रेड 2, यू कैन सी जस्ट mucosal prolapse and shortening of aryepiglottic fold. Retinoid is here, epiglottis is here. This aryepiglottic fold will be just shortened in grade 2. Grade 1 and grade 2, most of the time they will resolve completely. If the child is having proper omega sign, then the chance complete resolution is of a lesser chances. Okay, treatment हम बस पेशेंट्स का पेशेंट का पेरेंट को प्रॉपरली एजुकेट कर लो जो जो वार्निंग साइंस हो सकता है, साइनोसिस बार बार हो जा रहा है या चेस्ट रिट्रैक्शंस वगैरह होने लग गया है, ये सब है तो तुरंत मेडिकल इंटरवेंशन के लिए लाना है, अदरवाइज द पेशेंट कैन कंटिन्यू. और फीडिंग की टाइम थोड़ा ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा, एस्पिरेशन नहीं होना है, सो यू हैव टू कीप द पेशेंट्स और द चाइल्ड्स हेड मोर एलिवेटेड देन यूजुअल. ओके, ये सब करने के बाद भी आफ्टर वेटिंग फॉर इवन अप टू 18 मंथ्स इफ द पेशेंट इज नॉट इम्प्रूविंग या और कोई कॉम्प्लिकेशन में जल्दी पहुंचने लग गया तो देन यू हैव टू गो फॉर सर्जिकल इंटरवेंशंस लाइक सर्जिकल रिलीज ऑफ द शॉर्टेंड एरिएपिग्लॉटिक फोल्ड्स AEF नॉट EAF AEF एरिएपिग्लॉटिक फोल्ड्स, पार्शियल एक्सेशन ऑफ द रिडंडेंट एपिग्लॉटिस ऑफ द म्यूकोसल tightening, you excise the redundant excess mucosa and suture it, that is called as epiglottopexy or supra glottoplasty. All these surgical procedures can be performed only if the patient is reaching into any complications or even after 18 months the symptoms are not improving, then you have to go or think about surgical interventions. Second common cause for congenital stridor is subglottic stenosis. Okay, stenosis can even be caused by a cyst, subglottic cyst or congenital stridor. It can also be caused by Webb's cyst or any other craniofacial malformation or stridor ka cause hai. Just for stenotic appearance, the web, mucosal web and a mucosal retention cyst itself can cause subglottic stenosis. Okay, here subglottic stenosis we are seeing as a whole. Congenitally it is rare. The more common cause for subglottic stenosis is acquired and it is seen in adult population. Okay, if a child without any history of any intubation is coming with subglottic stenosis, then the cause can be congenital. Okay, acquired condition almost always follows a prolonged intubation, काफी वीक्स और मंथ्स इफ द पेशेंट वॉज इंटुबेटेड बाय एंडोट्रैकियल इंटुबेशन. ओके, देन बिकॉज ऑफ स्कारिंग विच इज कॉज्ड बाय कंटिन्यूअस ट्रॉमा कॉज्ड बाय द टिप ऑफ योर एंडोट्रैकियल ट्यूब, इंटुबेशन ट्यूब का जो टिप है इट कैन कॉज कंटिन्यूअस फ्रिक्शन एंड कैन कॉज स्कारिंग ऑफ द सबग्लॉटिक स्पेस. स्कारिंग की वजह से जो स्टेनोसिस होता है वट इज more common, acquired cause to jyada hai. Okay, and can be easily avoided by timely extubation. If the patient comes out of the indication to be on maintained endotracheal intubation, turant extubate kar lijiye, timely extubation karne se aap prevent kar sakte hain. Otherwise if the patient is not improving from the original pathology, whatever was the reason to intubate the patient, if the patient is not improving from that condition, then after 72 hours go for tracheostomy. You do the tracheostomy, you will save the subglottic space from going into stenosis. Tracheostomy, when the patient improves, then you can close the tracheostomy and you can wean the patient from ventilation. Okay, so even if it is an acquired condition, subglottic stenosis bhi ho rakha hai, so if it is a grade 4 stenosis, then there will be complete respiratory obstruction because there is 100% closure of the lumen. Okay, grade 1 it is from 0 to 50% only, grade 2 51 to 70% only, grade 2 is between 71 to 99%. Okay, up to grade 2 the patient might not be even symptomatic. Grade 3 mein thoda sa dyspnea ho sakta hai, thoda bahut stridor. If it is crossing more than 90%, then the patient might develop stridor. You can see only this much hole is seen. Okay, so up to grade 2 the patient might be asymptomatic. When will the grade 2 patient go and develop symptoms? Abhi itna lumen hai, and imagine this patient is developing some upper respiratory tract infection which can cause edema of the epithelium or this mucosa. So jo grade 2 mein tha, suddenly the patient can go into grade 3. From 2 to grade 3 the condition can suddenly progress or the condition can worsen into grade 3. Or if the patient was of grade 3 and if the patient develops local edema due to upper respiratory tract infection, grade 3 se complete obstruction mein turant ja sakte hain. So even if the patient is asymptomatic, they are like volcano which is ready to burst. Okay, if there is a overlying upper respiratory tract infection, normal coryza, common cold BHO, so turan the patient can deteriorate and the patient can go for respiratory obstruction, complete obstruction. So immediately you have to do tracheostomy and then think about what treatment you have to give for subglottic stenosis. Okay, so how will you diagnose? You do fiber optic laryngoscopy or bronchoscopy. You go and see the actual lumen of the subglottic region. So kitna kam ho rakha hai, everything you can mention. Okay, this grading is done by radiological investigation. Okay, this is 100%. Imagine this is properly wide, this is trachea, and this is subglottic region. Okay, how much narrowing is there compared to the normal subglottic zone, that you compare and you can grade the subglottic stenosis. Okay, here this is, I will put this into grade 3 because there is significant more than 70% obstruction. Okay, but I can still see a line going upwards, it can go upwards and continue. So this is not grade 4 but grade 3. To grade this, you have to compare both fiber optic laryngoscopy finding as well as x-ray findings, and then you can put it into this grading. Naming of this classification system is called as Myers-Cotton classification or Cotton-Myers grading system. Okay, so grade 1 and 2, they are easy to treat. Why do we have to even treat grade 1-2 when the patient is not asymptomatic? Because if the patient develops a respiratory tract infection, they can worsen suddenly. So grade 1-2 ko bhi hum treat karna hi chahenge. But wo endoscopic approach se hum kar sakte hain, kaafi bada surgery nahi hai. If you are seeing any small thin webs, wo laser se wo web ko aap transect kar lijiye, resect kar lijiye, kaam ho jayega. If you don't want to use any electrocautery or laser, any powered instruments you don't want to use, you just put in a balloon. There is a specific balloon dilator for subglottic stenosis or tracheal stenosis. Uske liye wo balloon ko aap intraluminally place kar lijiye and try to inflate the balloon. Ek pressure ke baad usko inflate karne mein jo stenosis tha wo break karke open ho jata hai. Okay, grade 3 and 4 mostly they will not be relieved by balloon dilatation or just resection of the webs. For that you have to, first step you have to go for tracheostomy, jise aap airway secure kar sakte hain, and then you have to go for procedures like partial cricotracheal resection, cricoid cartilage and trachea ka thoda partially jis segment mein stenosis hai pura resect karke aap end to end anastomose kar sakte hain, or you can go for laryngotracheal reconstruction. Okay, you can take costal cartilage, you split the cricoid cartilage in midline, anterior arch ko aap midline mein cut karke you can place a harvested cartilage from the costal cartilage, you can put it in between and you can make it as a wedge. Uske upar aap stitch karenge to the diameter can increase. Okay, these are all the surgical options available for subglottic stenosis. Treatment options are common for both congenital anomaly or the acquired. Dono ko treatment options, diagnostic approach sab ek hi hai. Inflammatory causes, this we will continue in the next class. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, we will read about the other causes, like aapka inflammatory conditions tha. We have seen up to congenital conditions. We will discuss in the next class, along with vocal cord paralysis, and we will start CL larynx side by side. CL larynx, it will take at least 2 classes. So we will start an introduction to CL larynx in the next class. उससे पहले हम बाकी स्ट्राइडर का जो जो कॉसेस है वो सब हम डिस्कस। ओके, थैंक यू
थैंक यू सर।